Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. I am so excited today. I'm visiting European Parliament in Strasbourg. Today it's open to the visitors whole day. So I thought why not visit this place and share the experience with you guys. So let's get started. I started from my place around 10:30 in the morning. Since the weather was very good, I decided to take my cycle. Do you know that Strasbourg is the best city to cycle in entire France? And just like most of the European cities, it has separate path for cyclists. One can also take tram E for European Parliament. If you're coming from Gare Central, you can take full day ticket in which you can take any public transport within city. We reached European Parliament at 11:15 am. And to be very frank, it didn't really look like a normal day at all. Usually there are no people around in normal day. But today, we could see crowd gathered over as if some fest is going on. After the security check, we were allowed to enter the so much talk about place. It was just humongous, guys. The building was so high, round in shape, that I felt intimidated by its size. Marvelous. Within the Agora, there were so many booths. Booths for kids to play, for Eurocorps. We also tasted red and white wine at the Portugal booth, which kind of gave it a kickstart we were looking for. Here is the map showing the path we followed, along with places that were open for public. On our way to Parliamentarium, in Director General Communication Area, we got our pictures clicked with all the flags. I also got a temporary tattoo done of European Parliament. See? As soon as we reached Parliamentarium, we had to wait for 15 to 20 minutes as there was long queue. Finally, our turn came to enter the Parliamentarium and we were allowed to move in. This place is where they feature stunning 360-degree cinema and had touchscreen tables. They also had feature to choose the language from all European Union languages as there are people visiting from across the Europe. This video helps visitors to better understand the role of the European Parliament and how it impacts the lives of citizens. The Parliamentarium lays out the process behind making law for the whole of Europe and explains what the members of the European Parliament are doing to meet the challenges of today. I couldn't film more, guys, as I myself was completely engrossed in the movie. On our way out to Parliamentarium, towards Hemicycle, we saw Bulgarian Council, a small, simple and a sweet section, and the main Parliament section where actual debates takes place. It was just huge people. The Hemicycle can seat all 751 members of the European Parliament. During plenary sessions, it is used for the largest and most important debates. It has provided the setting for many historic votes and visits of heads of states and governments as well as other notable figures. In front of every seat, there was a control panel where you can select different languages to listen and participate in debate. They also had microphones so that people can ask questions to the panel sitting in between. Following that were lots and lots of games and quizzes which were organized by specific groups providing briefings on the work of European Parliament. Earlier, we didn't know what it is. We just saw a queue form there, so we joined the crowd little knowing what was it. And guess what? We won the football in the Wheel of Fortune game. Yay! On the side note, we were four people and three of us got one pen. But the whole experience was so much fun. The next game was a quiz regarding European Parliament, and just for participating in the quiz, they were distributing sipper and mugs. For me, my visit was already sorted, guys, as I was receiving so many freebies. Pen, colors, keychain, bags, mugs, and whatnot. I didn't want to leave this section at all. I mean, who would want to lose all these gifts, guys? But we still had a lot to cover. We thought of playing our last game, where there were a bunch of small games clubbed together. And in that game, if we collect at least three of the cards, we would get a PCAP. Yet again, we geared up and we were all game and so competitive that we just went aboard and earned 4 caps. We were in full swing and we completely forgot what was our purpose to visit. We also visited ALDE group booth, which was basically about Alliance of Liberals and Democrats for Europe. For more information, you can visit their site. I will leave the link in the description box below. Following the map towards the Mediator building, we learned how the legislative procedure works at the European Parliament, how the proposals are adopted, how they are amended. The Mediator building is a completely separate section and is connected to the main building through the bridge over the river. The view from the bridge is spectacular. To much of our surprise, the Mediator section was very small and did not give much insight of what its purpose is. And since we were tired by then, we thought of calling it a day. On our way back, inside the campus itself, there was a very good cafeteria serving various kinds of refreshments to the visitor. We sat for some refreshment and moved towards the exit. At the Agora, our day ended with some Portuguese dance by some artists from Portugal itself and some more wine at the end. What a hell of a day it was. Hectic yet energetic. Full of fun yet learning. Full of excitement yet calming. To be very frank people, it was such a good mix of fun and knowledge. Each and every game and quiz we played was so well planned that it imparted knowledge about them as well as making it fun at the same time. Each and every section was very well organized. I hope we could see more of it. Thank you very much guys for watching this video. If you like it, then you know what to do. And yes, please do subscribe to my channel. On this note, this is Deepa signing off for now. Ahuwa.